We will now have an invocation about bringing it home.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, as we come today, we just want to thank you for another day alive. Thank you for being blessed out of Lake Fox today. Thank you for everything that you've done for us. Letting us gather here as an FFA chapter. Welcoming our fellow chapter members and families here, Lord. Just bless us with what we eat before long, Lord. Just use it for the nurses, for bodies, for Christ yourself.
If we'll get started with our meal here in just a second. We have two serving lines out in the foyer out there, so it'll go pretty quickly. We're going to let the head table go first. And after that, we will start with dismissing rows at a time. So Skylar Weddington is our newlywed center. Skylar, raise your hand. He's over here. He will come along to your table and tell you when to go get in line. So.
Or four. treasurer.
Stationed in Pullman, Washington.
Your duties there?
I keep a record of receipts and disbursements in Washington campus farm accounts, carefully and accurately. I encourage thrift among the members and strive to build up our financial standing through savings and investments. George Washington was better able to serve this country and see his financially independent.
The secretary.
Stationed by the airport.
Your duties there?
I keep an accurate record of all meetings and correspond with other secretaries where report is grown and educated is made.
The advisor.
By the house.
Why by the house?
The house, time-honored emblem of knowledge and wisdom. Being older than the rest of you, I'm asked to advise you from time to time as the need arises. I hope that my advice will always be based on true knowledge and right wisdom. Mr. Vice President, why do you keep a plow at your station?
The plow is a symbol of labor and tillage of the soil. Without labor, the knowledge and wisdom can accomplish much. My duties require me to assist at all times in directing the work of our organization and preside over meetings in the absence of our president. This place is beneath the rising sun.
Why is the president so stationed?
The rising sun is a testament of a new era in our country. We will follow the leadership of our president. We shall deliver the darkness of our selfishness to the glorious sun of our brotherhood cooperation. Madam President, all officers of our stations.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President. The secretary will now call the roll of members. There are 38.
Ms. Kelsey Woodruff, Extension Agent for Agriculture, Wade. We got questions about the garden, Mr. Brinkwater, retired ag teacher, that Faye Bowers is up here with us. Thank you for being here. Ms. Godby's family is over here. Glad to have you with us. Our family's here as well. Can't say enough about what our family's doing to us. And then all of the former FFA members, if you're a former FFA member, any chapter, any time, I'd like for all former FFA members to please stand up. Round of applause for these folks. FFA is a rich tradition. If you're new to our organization, we're very big on tradition, very big on family, and you're part of the FFA family. So appreciate all the former members being here. Parents, grandparents, friends, supporters, anybody that's here to celebrate these FFA members, we thank you all for being here tonight.
Madam Secretary, what is the next item of business?
Awards program, starting at Jordan Roberts.
Each year, many of our members attend speaking competitions at the regional level. There's a great deal of preparation and effort that goes into these competitions. If our members are represented in the chapter of the regional effort today, they want to. Also, please come forward when your name is called. Prepare public speaking, Jordan Roberts. Ag Mechanics, Brandon Carr. Crop, Kaylee Tom. Dairy, Emily Goodwin. Goat Chief, Cole Hall. Greenhouse, Michaela Rose. Horse, Sheldon Warrior. Small Animal, Kate Lawrence. Swine, Madison Gibson. Floral, Madison Animal. Michaela Probst finished superior first, and George Roberts finished superior second in the speaking contest and will compete in the state convention in June. Kohlhoff also earned superior ratings at the regional level. The Leadership Scholarship Award will now be presented by Kate Lawrence.
The participants in many leadership
Shannon Brown, Anne Kane, Ms. Mary Cowan, Eli Childers, Sierra Couch, Brady Urban, Julia King, Jimmy Ramirez, Madison Rogers, Jake Lowe, and Brady Wright.
Skills competitor was Sierra Couch. This year, we had four talented leaders that performed in the talent competition. They received a super second at FFA. The FFA talent competitors are Aiden Walton, Robert Roberts, Kyron Spears, and Cole Dolly.
Thank you.
fellowship team and their advisors. But many people are aware of the duties of the community chairs and secretaries. These members attend an executive meeting to inform the members of the chapter of activities that have passed and plan activities in the future. The committee chairs are leadership, Tony McQuarrie, scholarship, Madison Hamm, financial, Kate Barnes, stakeholder engagement, Karen Spears, citizenship, Gracie Singleton, personal love, Brandon Harmon, recruitment, Scott Legend, advocacy, Kelly Huffman, advocacy, Madison Gibson.
The silver pin of the chapter of the Banquet is awarded for second, third, and fourth year members who advanced their SAE program and activity this year. This year's chapter for your recipients are Lacey Balling, Kate Morris, Dylan Kane, Brittany Carter, Zeta Cox, Hunter Nelson, Casey Ellis, Madison Gibson, Destin Harris, Isaiah Johnson, Tanner Lee, Trevor Coyne, Sheldon McQuarrie, Emily Ross, senior educators are sending the state programs at the Bay Area. Members will receive their state degree at the state of the Bay Area in June.
Secretary, what's the next item of business?
Honoring membership, farmers, school superintendents,
those who are to receive this honor. Madam President, members and guests, I am pleased to read these names. Ms. Leia Godby, Mr. Marvin Godby, and Ms. Susan Godby.
This year's starting placement demonstrates leadership at a very high level.
Some of our other paid activities include the Brethren Giving Team, FFA Camp, Committee Chair, Chapter Secretary, Quiz Bowl Contest, and many local activities. This year's Casey County FFA Star in Agricultural Placement is Ms. Michaela Price. So we have something new this year that we are very blessed, excited about. We've had the opportunity to present scholarships to underclassmen for their SATs. This money will be used to start or improve their current supervised agricultural experience programs. If you're not familiar with those, they're a major part of a student's agricultural experience and agricultural education. They can range from traditional farm projects to job placements, improvement, or research projects. These very deserving students have worked hard to plan and implement a quality SAE. They will be awarded with a scholarship to continue their project and further their learning or research. Mr. Godby and I are very excited to see how they're going to spend their SAE scholarship money when we come to your summer visits. Tonight's sponsors for the $150 SAE scholarships are Casey County Conservation District, the Casey County Farm Bureau Federation, Oak Hill Cattle, the Price, Keene, and Johnson family, and Casey County Vet Services, Dr. Courtney Rockman. Eli Childers, Dallas Moore, you all need to come up and get your certificate. There we go, come on. All right, we're going to start up. Eli Childers, Dallas Moore, Shelby McQuarrie, Braden Irvin, Kaylee Todd, Cole Godfrey, Kyron Spears, Skylar Weddington, Landon Bullington, Emily Goode, Brandon Carman, Sierra Couch, Jake Weddle, and Ann Taylor Payne. Again, this is something new that we're able to do for our FFA members, so we greatly appreciate the sponsorship from our sponsors and all of their support. Up next, Mr. Alan Godby will be giving out our Vote Ag scholarships.
Before we move on to scholarships, just a couple of names to make that call. Where it's possible, they might have left off the list for scholarship awards. Mr. Jerry Henson. Ms. Annabelle Chaffin. We're going to give out four scholarships tonight.
to very deserving young people who know what FFA is all about and who represent our chapter very well. They value hard work, love for agriculture, and have a commitment to excellence. We've got a lot of supporters, sponsors who have stepped up to donate money to make these scholarships possible, and we're very thankful for them. Our first scholarship tonight is going to be sponsored by the Casey County Academics Association. The recipient of this scholarship is Ms. Jenna Wood. Jenna's the daughter of Josh and Ken Whittington. She plans to attend Murray State University this fall, which is my major in agriculture. Our next $500 scholarship is sponsored by the Casey County Bank. It's going to go to Mr. Jordan Roberts. Jordan is the son of Pam Roberts. He plans to attend Lindsey Wilson College. He's going to major in criminal justice. Our next scholarship is sponsored by the Casey County Bank as well. It goes to Ms. Kelly Probst. Kayla is the daughter of Michael and Casey Probst. She plans to attend Campbellsville University and study cosmetology. And our last scholarship tonight is donated by the Casey County Bank as well. It's going to go to Ms. Madison Hammond. Let's give all of our scholarship to the recipients.
Madam Secretary, what is the next item of business? The presentation of the requiring officer speeches. As long as we learn how we came out, as though we did when we
Mr. Scott being my second mom, someone I look up to and by far the hardest person to lead. The person I go to for anything and everything, because you always have the best advice. You taught me to take all my roads to the buses, and I tried to enjoy your work the best you could find. When I didn't want to be at school, you could probably find me a teacher. You were always ready to listen, whether we needed a warm smile to cheer us up, or a pat on the back, a laugh, you could find in the night. We really do have the best of both worlds in the basement, mom and dad. To the retiring officers, I have enjoyed standing by your side at every meeting and event. We may be retiring our jackets, but the memories will last forever. As we go our separate ways, we will always be proud to be part of the Casey County and the Faye chapter. Without the Faye, we would not be who we are today. To the new officer team, be involved and enjoy every moment. Your officer positions are all well deserved. Your part is never too small. You all play a role in making this chapter as great as it is. This might be the end for us, but it is the start of something new for you. I am sad to leave this chapter and all the amazing people within it, but I am so lucky to say that I will be part of it. We may be retiring from graduates, but we will never forget the teamwork, laughs, and fun times and the favor of us. Thank you.
My apron, who's always ready for a while. And my apron is always
She also does pretty good hair. Eli, Skyler, Braylon, Jaylen, and Amelia. I want to thank you guys for helping me with everything. From feeding cows, to dragging you guys along to help these cow shows, to putting up with my 80 farm foods. You guys are here for me. And it's still in my head and always been great for my life, for next class. I love you guys. Gravy, Dana, thank you for always letting me, even though I may ask you to go on runs to the tractor supply and get penicillin, or maybe coming to your house covered in mud or manure. You guys still love me and all my biggest supporters. Poppy. If you ever met my grandpa, you've never had a problem. Poppy has been such a good support for me, from helping me wrangle up the cows with his dog cart, to holding me when I get shot.
Tired and looked at me.
saving grace of the collegiate today. And so I guess then I want to hear your reactions.
Alan said I have 2 minutes, so I'm going to try not to go over the I can't make any promises. First of all, I'd like to thank God for giving me the opportunity to do this. I would also like to thank my parents, siblings, and friends for supporting me in the 4 years I've been in the NFL. I'd also like to thank Alan and Jimmy for never giving up on me and setting a good example for what a leader should be. Over the last 4 years, the NFL has completely changed my life. If you would have told me 4 years ago that I would be standing in front of you today and talking about the words of their meeting, the amount of experiences that I've had and the memories I've made will last a lifetime. I remember walking ahead of freshman year thinking it was going to be an easy A. To say I was wrong is an understatement. I was introduced to the great organization of the FFA, and I will forever be grateful for that. With COVID starting in 2020, right at the start of me and the class of 2023's FFA tournaments, a lot was uncertain. But through it all, FFA was there. FFA and our culture became a second home to me. The same place as people. And that is something that I will carry with me for life. All the bonds I've made in the FFA have been great, and one of the ones that stuck out to me was our talent team this year. The amount of hours that me, Cole, Hank, and Kyra spent on correcting every single detail of the song was not easy, and ultimately made us all become really close together. If I had to guess, I would say we spent 30 hours working on that song together. Also, to be on this stage and compete in the speaking competition is still unreal. Last year, I came away with an excellent rating in the Beef and Prompting Speaking Competition, and I was devastated. To be completely honest, I wasn't sure if I'd ever compete in speaking contest again, but this year, I took on an even harder speaking competition with the Prairie Public Speaking and came away with second place. That is a true example of why you should never give up. If I could give one piece of advice with all the younger FFA members out there, it would be to do as much as you can. I can truly say it has never been an FFA event or competition that I've ever disliked. With that being said, I want to leave you all with a quote that I put in my officer speech a year ago that ultimately has me stand here tonight. Do not fear failure, rather fear my triumph. By Willie T. Bennett.
Such an incredible impact on me and my life. Thank you. Madam Secretary, what is the next item of business? Installation of mayor offices. On April 12, 2023, the nominating committee met to analyze applications and interview candidates for FFA offices for the 2023-2024 school year. The nominating committee recommends the following members to be installed in their respective officer position at this time. As your name is called, please come forward to accept the office in which you were elected. President Cole Godby. Vice President Kaylin Todd. Secretary Emily Goode. Treasurer Shelby McQuarrie. Reporter Madison Gibson. Sentinel Skylar Weddington. Chaplain Brandon Corman. And historian Kate Lawrence. It is an honor to be an officer at the FFA. From time to time during the year, you may encounter difficult problems with your preparation, hard work, and determination. You will succeed and the FFA will prosper. You each of you accept the responsibilities of your office and we do your best to uphold the ideals and principles of the FFA. If so, answer what we do. I now declare each of you properly and duly installed in the respective office to which you were elected. May your year of service be marked by integrity, dedication, and cooperative spirit. Retired officers, we need to escort the newly installed officers to their stations.
Madam Secretary, you have a record of any further business that should now be transacted. Will the newly elected officers please present the retiring officers with their plaques? Madam Secretary, do you have a record of any further business which should now be transacted?
All SAE and Novak scholarship recipients, please stay for adventure. We also need all the STAR and STAR group names to stay for adventure as well.
Does any member know of any new or unfinished business which should properly come before this meeting? We are about to turn this meeting to Casey County on the paycheck. As we mingle with others, let's be diligent in labor, just in our dealings, courteous to everyone, and above all, honest and fair in the game of life. Fellow members and guests, join me in a salute to our flag. I now declare this meeting adjourned.